Oh, there it is.
All right, guys, we are live. I just wanted to say, too, come on over to Bungie.net and join the BRC clan. It is your destiny. What's going on, guys? It's been a great week. We got plenty of stuff to talk about. We are live with the Beastly Thoughts Show. We got the Beastly Gamer here. We got 9 to 5 Gamers here. And, of course, we got Robbie.
So let's get into it.
What have you guys been playing all week? I can't wait to hear about it. Beastly, I'm going to go with you last because of our little experience after the show on Sunday night last week. So let's start off with 9 to 5 Gamers. What have you been playing this week?
I played the Velocity 2X, and I beat that.
Now that it's a shooter, right? It's old school shooter, not a first person shooter.
No, it's a side scroller and a traditional
spaceship shooter. Like Asteroids in a sense. But there's parts where you got to get out and then do a puzzle, and then once you do the puzzle, you get back in your ship and you fly to the next area. Mm-hmm. But it's great. I highly recommend everyone download
Blaster
that if
Master?
You have it. Yeah, kind of. Yeah, same deal almost.
Okay.
They're liking
wow,
that
that's old school. You brought up some old school games.
They are comparing that game to Sonic the Hedgehog when Sonic the Hedgehog was actually good because it's so much that you have to do in such quick succession, teleporting your shit back and forth. It's a very fast-paced game. I played it briefly, too. Real fun.
Yeah. And then I picked up Metro, Madden, and Minecraft as well.
Metro, so that's the new
compilation
disc? Triple M's.
Yeah, right. Minecraft. I never thought about that. I've been playing my Ultimate Team on Madden, which I'm loving. That I always do the Ultimate Teams on all EA sports games. Like, I do the same with FIFA a lot.
Picked that really up on the Xbox One or the PS4?
I picked up Madden on PS or Madden on Xbox. I picked up Metro on PS4, and then I picked Minecraft up on Xbox.
All right, let's start talking about Metro, because I've always been intrigued by those games, but I've never actually played them. That is a two-disc set, right? It's got both 2033 and New Light on it?
Last Light.
No, Last Light.
Okay. So have you started playing them? What do you think so far? Is it a nice graphical upgrade, or does it just look like an up-res version of the old game? What's it look like?
The cool thing about that I noticed the most about the first one is the first one they used lots of fog to back down the draw distance, and they did that through the whole game.
Mm-hmm.
And when you play the first one on the new consoles, it's like the fog is completely gone, and you can see everything. Okay. It's amazing. It looks really good for being a game that was out damn near 2 years ago on PC. About 2 years ago. The game looks really solid on the next-gen consoles or current-gen consoles.
Have you gotten pretty far? Are you playing the first one or the second one?
I'm playing the first one just as like a refresher. I know the second one is supposed to look like ridiculously good. Mm-hmm. So I wanted to play the first one just as a refresher, though.
Yeah, absolutely. Are you enjoying the story?
It's all on the same disc, too, which is crazy to me. I thought it was going to be a two-disc set, too, and then I opened it. I was like, damn, they fit that all on one disc?
That's nice. The power of Blu-ray.
Yeah.
Yes, sir.
Screw you, HD DVD.
I wonder who still has those Xbox 360s HD DVD little setups, man.
I still got it. So how was Madden? What are you thinking about Madden so far?
I haven't played Madden since Brett Favre was on the cover, so like I think that was like 2011 or 12 or some crazy shit like that.
Mm-hmm.
So I decided to pick up this year's, and I'm loving it. I like it a lot. They pretty much fixed every gripe I had about the game, with like the movement of the players. They put them pretty much back to how 2K had all the controls, which is smart. Like where the right stick is juke and your hit stick. And then you can also spin and do all that stuff on a different one, which that's mainly what EA needed to do with Madden, was fix their controls.
Okay. All right, what was the third game? Was it
Minecraft?
Yeah. Is this your first experience with Minecraft, or...?
Yeah, and man, I could have drove down the street and threw $20 out the window, like, to be honest with you. I don't really like it. It's very bland and boring. It's... I get you have to have a creative mind... But mm-hmm. if I wanted to play something creative, I'd play Little Big Planet. Like, not to be a dick, but I don't really like the game. It's not good. It's
so, now, for me, I gotta think the difference.
The difference between playing that on a PC and on a console is big, because on a PC you can mod it and you can almost play any game you want. You know, you can be playing the Hunger Games, you can be playing a deathmatch in a Modern Warfare 3 level. I mean, you can be doing almost anything in that game because the people who are creating mods for that game are so creative. So even though, you're technically playing Minecraft, you're playing dozens and dozens worth of different games. But on the console, you're really just playing straight-up Minecraft. So there's a lot less to it, you know?
The coolest part to me about it was when, on the Xbox version, they give you, like, a Halo edition thing, like where you get in a Halo map or a Skyrim, or there's one other one. But when you get in the Halo one, they play the Halo music, which I thought was really fucking cool.
That's cool as well. Yeah. It is awesome. All right, Robbie, what have you been playing?
Yeah, I've been playing tons of Minecraft. See, Justin, I actually like Minecraft quite a bit. It is a very acquired taste. Like, it's definitely not for everybody, especially if you're doing it. Can be pretty confusing, but I like Minecraft, especially playing with friends. It can be a lot of fun. And I've also been playing, Velocity. That is an awesome, awesome game. And, that's about it. Just been playing a lot of Minecraft and Velocity.
All right. Beastly, talk to me about what you've been playing this week. And when you're done, let's talk about Last of Us a little bit.
Of course, I've been playing Last of Us. I did play some Velocity. I wouldn't play some PlayStation All-Stars Battle Royale because that's free on PlayStation Plus.
Okay, that's a fighting game with all the PlayStation brand characters, right?
Yeah, it's basically Smash Brothers with Sony PlayStation characters. And it's a good game. It's just different than Smash Brothers, and so the reason I think that game didn't do as well as it could have is that a lot of people thought that they were just biting the whole idea from Nintendo, but the game is very different as far as the way it plays and what the objective is in the game.
Okay,
I actually got that game originally when it first came out, but I still like to get my digital downloads too. I played Joe Danger on my PlayStation Vita, which is like Excite Bike on cocaine, and of course
good.
I've been... Yeah.
Is that a new free game?
Yeah, it's free for PlayStation Vita right now, as well as Velocity 2X. So
is it literally like Excitebike? Like you're riding a motorcycle across the level?
Yeah, that's exactly what it is. Of course, it's a graphical upgrade, and you're doing all kinds of crazy loops, and you have to keep your Joe Danger level. It's kind of like what's the motorcycle game that came out a few months ago?
Trials.
It's like that. Yeah, but it's more zany. It's kind of like Super Dave, if you guys remember that old show.
Super Dave Osborne, sure.
Yeah, it's a crazy-ass dude, and it's pretty fun. And, of course, I've been playing a lot of The Last of Us and really enjoying that. I did play some Call of Duty this week, but after about an hour, I had to go back to The Last of Us. It's just such a different experience for me. But, it's been a really good week for gaming for me.
All right. So I think we should tell the story of... playing some Last of Us together last week.
Oh, I remember.
So, Robbie was there. Robbie was there too. Yeah.
After the show, I don't know how to approach this even. Maybe I'll let you tell the story, and then I'll just interject with my account of it as it goes. Or maybe I'll start telling the story, and you can interject with your...
I know the story ends with bitch move. But
pretty much.
That's what it is. we got into some Last of Us multiplayer, and Briar Rabbit, just for the guys who don't know, he never really got a chance to play the multiplayer at all.
That's right. So I played the game when it was new on the PlayStation 3, and that's basically the last time I've had a controller in my hand with Last of Us for more than about a half hour. When I first brought the PS4 version home, I played the single player for about 30 minutes, and then I hadn't picked it up again.
Yeah, and so when we got into the multiplayer... He immediately was upset about the controls. He said, "I want Call of Duty controls. I want to be able to change."
Well, you can't.
Call of Duty.
Not only can you not change the control options for the game, but you can't even see the control options while you're playing the game. So I'm asking Beastly while we're playing, okay, which one's the run button? Which one's the reload button? Which one's? And I'm thinking, I'm saying out loud, like, why did they change every goddamn button? Like, why can't reload always be X? Why do you have to change that to be something else, you know? Why can't run always be clicking the stick? Or at least give me the option to change it so I don't have to relearn a controller every time I play a game. Anyway, go ahead.
And so we were having issues getting into an actual multiplayer match.
That's right.
I guess their servers are screwing up and we're unable to join. So
I thought they decided to come that, but apparently not.
It worked immediately after you left. It worked immediately after. It was so crazy. But we went into a private match, and so it wasn't really competitive. Of course, Briar Rabbit, as soon as he saw me, he started shooting because that Call of Duty gene is in him. He said, moving target, blah, blah. We went to the damn stage, and we played around a little bit. I was teaching him some fundamentals of the game. And it kind of got one-sided real quick because I played the game a lot.
Yeah, so
I can imagine how frustrating it was. Yeah.
We jumped into a one-on-one game, and Beastly says to me, well, I'll go light on you, like teach you some of the controls. I think maybe like the first four kills, I probably had one of those first four kills. And then I'm walking down a corridor, and all of a sudden I'm fucking dead. I'm like, hey, what happened? Beastly's leaving these little bitch grenades all over the place. So I'm like, all right, I gotta watch out for those things. I never actually saw it, so I couldn't actually identify it until
then. Oh, like, man, so that's a great name for it. That's what it should be called in the game. It's a bitch grenade.
So I'm running around a little bit more, and Beastly says, "Be careful. Be very aware." So I see an ammo box. You know how they kind of have like the toolkits out there that you can grab stuff out of. I'm like, oh great, I can run over there and grab stuff. I don't know what I'm gonna do with it yet because I haven't learned the crafting system, but I know I'm supposed to get stuff out of there. I run over to it, I open it up, and I explode. There was a bitch grenade in the toolkit.
That's Beastly's move, man. He does that shit to everybody.
So Beastly just starts laughing hysterically. Like, you know, he should be doing at the time. And we keep playing. Robbie joins. And now it's me and Robbie versus Beastly. And I'm learning how to use that listen mode, which I don't understand why they call it listen mode, because it's purely a visual experience. But anyway, I'm using that. And I see Beastly around the corner, so I come over, I raise my gun up to shoot him, and he starts whacking me with a fucking machete. And that's when I kind of realized, oh, this game is basically everything I hate about Call of Duty. Dude's camping in the corner with IEDs and, like, super knives. I was like, okay, I understand. This game's so good.
It's so good, everybody. It's so good. I had a lot of fun playing with you and Robbie, but I guess it's not for everybody. It's kind of like Robbie said with Minecraft. It's an acquired taste.
You know what? I played a little bit afterward, though. I played in some public matches. I was still not able to get into a lobby with friends, but just playing some regular pub matches, I can see where you're coming from. It ends up being a lot of fun. The fun runs out for me just like it does with Call of Duty. It's like I instantly want to leave a lobby once somebody's using a lot of those grenades. And it's not necessarily when people are lobbing the grenades. It's when people are just leaving them in corners that you couldn't possibly see. You know, you're running through a doorway and all of a sudden you get blown up.
But the thing is, you haven't played long enough to know, but I guess. But when you go to listen mode, you can actually see the grenades. You can see them wherever they are. So, and a lot of people don't place them. A lot of people don't place them the way that I do. I normally put them exactly inside of a box. A lot of people find it really hard to do. And most people just carry them just to throw them when they need to. So I guess it all depends on what you're playing with. But always.
But when I found a lobby that somebody was doing what you were doing, I basically left the lobby. I didn't want any part of that because it wasn't fun. The other thing is the melee stuff. It feels, I don't know, it just feels wrong to me. After I put three slugs into a guy and he walks up to me and I can never fire my gun again because he's just in this like endless animation and hit me with a melee. I didn't like that much at all either. And the pace of the game, you know, I'm used to a fast-paced shooter, so the fact that you can't see a guy in listen mode if he's being absolutely like he's not moving at all, that definitely is a part of the game that promotes camping to effect that I can't dig with. It's like, I don't like games where people camp, and that game definitely promotes camping.
It may promote it in a sense, but you hardly ever see anybody really
That wasn't my experience. I saw a lot of people camping.
Playing with these toys, campers. It's just camping the whole time. Laying bitch grenades everywhere and hiding with machetes in the corner. So.
Can't oh, shut up, Robbie. You know that you can't say that shit about me. I'll be gone, y'all.
I just did. I just did. I think I just did. So.
You better watch my gameplays.
I do watch your gameplays, and they're impressive. I like watching them. That's why I recommended that you make a tips and tricks video, and I watched your tips and tricks video, too. And when I got into a online game, it definitely helped me out because it was actually – I had fun playing it in an online setting, but just not as much fun as I'd have playing Call of Duty or Destiny or something like that.
Totally understandable. Totally understandable.
Beastly.
Yes, sir.
Tell them about that. Tell them about that fucking guy that was cheating that one day.
Oh God! And how many times did we shoot him before he went down? Like 10 times.
We hit him with like 2 Molotov cocktails, a bomb, and we shoot him in the face.
Yeah, I actually have that video still on this computer.
Oh, you should put that up.
There are people who use hacks. There's already PS3 hacks with unlimited Molotovs, bombs, unlimited health, unlimited ammo. These people run around. And they still have fun destroying the whole team. But there was a guy, I forget which map, I know which map it was, the name is escaping me, but I threw a bomb right next to him. The bomb exploded. He stood up, I shot him 3 times, 9 to 5 started shooting him, they hit him with 2 Molotov cocktails, and he still didn't go down. And that there frustrates the hell out of me. I don't like shooting.
And then Beastly sends this guy a chat invite to join our chat.
Yeah, yeah, he did.
He joined our chat. And he's saying, who the fuck are you calling a cheater? And he was like yelling about it. I was like, oh, man, this is going to become a big deal right now.
Yeah, I had to let him know I was black with that argument. Motherfucker. we talked, and I told the guy that if you had to cheat to make yourself feel better in a game, then you're really just a scrub. I mean, he said it's all skill. I said skill doesn't make you have unlimited health, you know? And that's for all you cheaters out there. You can kiss my ass.
He was 105 in the game, like rank-wise. He was 105, which I get. You're going to be good. But there's no way you're going to take all the damage we put on you, man.
Yeah, like, well, I mean, my gun downed you. The gun that I use, the semi-auto, downed you in 3 shots.
3 bullets, yeah.
The revolver downed you in 3 shots.
Yeah, I like the weapons in that game. It's fun. Like, they're all different, and they're fun to use.
It's just a very slow and deliberate experience, and for me, I like that sometimes. Sometimes in Call of Duty, things are so fast, I don't get a chance to think. You know, you come up the stairs, and all of a sudden, you just got taken out from the side by somebody you didn't even see. But in The Last of Us, you get more of an opportunity to slow down, think about what's going on, who's around you, what you can do to slow them down, whether to push forward or whether to retreat. It's just a lot more, for me, a mental battle as far as well as, you know, guns a-blazing type of experience.
Yeah. Yeah. So I also played some more Diablo 3 Reaper of Souls, and I finally got to the Reaper of Souls expansion pack, or the newest part of that game, and I'm really digging it. It's a nice long expansion. It's only one act, but they introduced some new characters. You get to fight some old characters. Man, the loot is stunningly good. I'm playing on Veteran. And I'm a little disappointed with that game because it's a little too easy on Veteran. And that's the hardest difficulty that you have unlocked to start with. You have to beat the game to get higher difficulties. But other than that, I'm really enjoying that game. I think it's a lot of fun. I think I'll probably drop it as soon as Destiny comes out on Tuesday. Just because the games are so similar in the loot grinding aspect. But I'm really enjoying it.
And Destiny's going to be better.
It's got my heart aching. I know when Destiny comes out Tuesday, it's going to be hard for me to play The Last of Us. As much as I love The Last of Us, that desire to learn everything about Destiny and find all the loot and the experience that we're going to have together playing it, it's going to it's like a newborn baby.
Dancing.
You love your newborn, even though you love your other children, but the newborn gets all the damn attention.
Yeah,
and then
Last
your
of Us
looks at you like you don't love me anymore.
Dancing is really underrepresented in Last of Us. I don't know if it's a tonal thing or
they're like, no, don't do that. Do something.
I don't want to see Joel bust a move. I think he can do it. He's got it in him.
Motherfucker better get down and do the worm.
That's right. I think that guy carries around cardboard with him, so he's doing like breakdancing and shit in the streets. But yeah, I'm really excited for Destiny. I mean, it's so close now that it's almost like the anticipation has moved on to impatience. You know, like I'm just like, all right, just like let me play it already.
Let me ask you guys a question about this is Destiny related, and this news just came out fairly recently, 2 or 3 days ago. Whereas if you pre-order or buy the game on the last gen consoles, you get the free upgrade to the current gen consoles.
Yeah.
What do you guys think about this? Talk to the people viewing and tell them what they should do or what your ideas and thoughts are on this promotion.
So I got a question real quick. You get both versions of the game then?
Yes. Yeah.
So you'll get one on PS3 and one on PS4.
Yes.
So why the fuck isn't everybody buying it on PS3 or Xbox 360?
That's what everybody's going to do.
You know what I'm saying? Like, that does it go vice versa? Do you get one for the old console?
No,
you
it doesn't. That's what Robbie... I actually made a video about this explaining the whole thing. Basically, if you got until January 15th, if you buy Destiny on the PS3 or the Xbox 360, you get a free upgrade voucher to upgrade to the next-gen consoles. But you get to also keep those last-gen consoles, versions. So you'll actually have two certified versions of the game. Now, for me, I got 5 PS3s in my house. I got, I got one in my room that I use, and here, the living room. My kids have one in their rooms. And so with me, I'm going to pre-order. I'm going to just completely get rid of the PS4 pre-order that I have and go ahead and buy the digital version for the PS3 in my room, share that with my sons, and then go ahead and upgrade in here in the living room. So I'm going to get 3 copies of Destiny for the price of 1 game.
That's crazy.
The only reason I'm not doing that is because I got that special edition. The one that
comes you with don't cancel out. That.
Yeah, I'm not.
Cancel that. You're never going to find that damn thing. that's the only Witcher.
I'm not doing that.
The Witcher reserves are already done, and it doesn't come out till next year.
I think this is ingenious, but the only thing I don't like about it is I don't buy normally digital versions of games.
Yeah.
I like to have physical copies of my game so I can, actually have something tangible to hold. But
yeah, but it's so much more convenient to have.
Yeah, this deal is too good to let go.
Yeah.
This deal is too good to pass up. And that's just period. So,
especially for a game that you're planning on playing and playing and playing. You know, because while I'm playing Destiny, there's going to be other games that come out and I play. You know, Advanced Warfare is definitely going to be one of those games. What else? I mean, there's a ton of stuff, right? I actually don't want to go through the whole list because we're going to do that again later. But, just being able to say, okay, I feel like playing some Destiny. I don't even have to go find the disc. And if I have 2 consoles, one upstairs, one downstairs, I don't have to bring the disc upstairs and downstairs. I just boot it up and go, and it's faster.
Yeah.
I love the digital future.
I'd probably be more in that camp if the whole 2011 PSN down issue didn't happen that even affected games that weren't online. There are certain even single-player games were inoperable when PlayStation Network went down. And so for me, having a digital version of a game isn't bad, but that stigma is always in the back of my mind. What if something goes wrong? Will it affect my gameplay? Will it affect me being able to play this experience that I've already paid for? So in the back of my mind, physical copies will always be better just because of the, even as minute as a chance that it might be, something going wrong at the network that will affect your single player or multiplayer experience at home. That's the only reason that I'm not, totally in the camp of digital versus physical. But I think that Bungie and Activision are doing something that no other video game company has ever done before. I know a dev has never done this, where you get a free upgrade. Basically, this is a 10-year plan that they've come up with to make Destiny relevant for 10 years. Because it's basically an MMO. And I think it's genius because they want everybody to have the game. They want to, blanket the streets with Destiny. It's going to be on all consoles across the board, except for Nintendo consoles, of course. Xbox 360, PS3s, and PS4. So even if you get a PS4 for Christmas and you buy the PS3 version now, you get the PS4 version for free.
Yeah.
It's unheard of that they're doing this, and in the back of my mind, I'm wondering how they're able to sustain such a huge profit giving away the game so many times. But they obviously have a big plan to make a lot of money off this game, and it looks like it's going to work because I know right now that's like the hottest subject out there, getting this game for free on next gen consoles.
Last year, I thought it was a fantastic deal when like Call of Duty and Battlefield all said, all right, if you have the 360 version for $10, you can upgrade it to the PS4 version. But this is by far a better deal because not only is it free, but you also get to keep your old version. So you can continue to play it on your PS3 or Xbox 360 once you upgrade. I think it's phenomenal. It's an unbelievably good value. Do the characters transfer over? Does anybody know?
They do. Your characters and the data, all the transfers.
Can you go back and forth?
I don't know about that. But I do know that it does. It transfers from the last to the current without any issue. I don't know about going back and forth. But still, even if it doesn't, damn it, this is a great deal. I mean, it's unlike anything I've seen before. I think Destiny will probably be... How will they rate this, though? How will they say it's the best-selling game if they give it away so many times? I mean, one out of every maybe two or three Destinies that'll be owned will be bought now. Because have a friend with a PlayStation, you can share... PlayStation users share their PSN information all the time.
I got Destiny. That's technically stealing. So most stolen game ever?
You can do it with two.
Most stolen game ever?
No. With PlayStation, you're actually legally allowed to... You can share with up to two different consoles. They don't have to be in the same household. They changed this 3 years ago. It used to be four PlayStation 4s, but now it's two PS4s. So if you have a PS4 and your friend has a PS4, you can legally share your account with that person.
Mm-hmm. A PS4?
I mean PS3, I'm sorry.
I was about to say, you can't do that on PS4, can you?
Yeah, PS3, I'm sorry.
I'm calling my buddy right now.
I'm sure the PS4 has something similar. I think it's two. I think it's two across the board. Really?
I don't think you can. I'm almost positive you can't.
Wow, I'd have to look into that. I'd be really upset if I had two PS4s here right now, and I bought a game on one, and I couldn't play it on the other. That seems like it's very unlikely to me that
you have to, you have to have your primary be on both systems. You know what I'm saying? So your primary account has to be logged into both systems, and that has to be your primary one. Oh, I think that's the way you got to do it.
So the games are tied to the sign-in ID.
Yeah.
Okay. That's still acceptable. That's still acceptable. Yeah, as long as I have a PS4 downstairs and a PS4 upstairs, and I can play Destiny on both, I'm happy. So I want that. Guys, I want that white PS4.
I just want to ask that. Yeah.
I'm all over the thing like women on rice. Or a PS4.
Yeah. It's a very attractive system. It's something I want as well, man.
Yeah, I actually like the white Xbox One better, like just as far as looks go. I think it looks cooler.
Yeah, the Sunset Overdrive bundle. That thing's going to be a beast.
Yeah. I'm definitely getting that. I might not get it right away, but I want a second PS4 just to have down in the living room so that, you know, me and the kids can just chill out on the couch and play some multiplayer games. Go ahead.
When this is all said and done, I'm going to have everything. Mm-hmm. You know, the white PS4, the white Xbox One, the Wii U, everything's going to be in here. It's just, being an adult is so damn hard prioritizing, you know, taking care of kids and taking care of a household. And I feel pretty fortunate just to have the video games that I have right now.
Right, yeah.
You know, dealing with the family and dealing with priorities and wanting, you know, that child inside wanting to buy this console now versus the adult saying, nah, it's not necessary. You got other things to do first.
Yeah, you got to pay rent and buy food.
When all things are said and done, I'm going to have everything. I'm just waiting for the right opportunity, you know?
Yeah.
The time is right. Got to find another guy with a coat.
That's a nice oversized coat you have there.
Yeah, it's huge.
You mind doing me a favor?
Ninja Turtle, yeah.
So, a lot has been talked about the new 3DS. We talked about this a little bit last week, but I think the gamers are pretty pissed off about this thing. Now, Beastly, I think you were pretty upset about it last week too, right?
I'm not upset about it. I don't think it's, you know, necessarily a bad thing. I just think it's not a good thing that, you know, every 2 or 3 years there's a new 3DS that comes out, and now they have one that actually is more powerful than the old. And so the people who bought the 3DS XL feel like they're left behind, you know?
Yeah. I looked at a timeline that said the original 3DS came out in, I think it was 2011. Is that right?
Yeah.
Early 2011.
Then the XL came out in 2012. Then the 2DS came out in 2013. And the new DS, 3DS is coming out, well, in Japan this year, and next year it'll be in North America.
Yeah, it's just, I feel like it's too soon, and on top of it being too soon, you're alienating your own, you know, fan base by creating a system that can do things as far as technical aspects, as far as the hardware that the others couldn't. Now, I can understand, you know, a new analog or a new physical functionality, but when you actually create a new hard, a new system that is able to play games that the other ones aren't,
yeah,
you're really alienating your own fan base, and even the people buying this new one, what do they have to look forward to in another year or two? The next rendition of the 3DS that is able to, you know, play games that this one isn't? I just feel like Nintendo is kind of alienating their own fan base when they, to me, they should be putting this technical effort into revolutionizing the Wii U and making it more on par with its competition.
Yeah. Yeah. Okay. Did you see the? Go ahead, Robbie.
My. You want to go, Robbie? Go ahead.
I wasn't gonna say anything. I was just
sorry. That was my mistake. Go ahead.
Both wearing red shirts. They're both wearing red shirts. Okay.
No. My big gripe about it is the new 3DS is more like a half step than a whole step towards their old system. It's not that big of a difference. It's gonna run Wii games. You know, like, I get that. That's cool. But at the same time, how many games that they have are going to be released? They have Xenoblade Chronicles coming out right now, which is an amazing game. But unless you release the whole library, it's not going to fucking matter.
And how many Wii games do you really care about on a handheld? I mean, the Wii, the whole purpose of the Wii was the motion controls. So what are the best Wii games that are going to be really compatible with this thing?
Yeah, playing Metroid Prime or any of the Metroid games on there is going to be stupid, because the big thing about Metroid was using the Wiimote to control it.
Yeah. Yep. Yeah. Yep. Yeah. Anybody going to buy the Super Smash Brothers Wii? Or not Wii, 3DS?
I love Smash Brothers, and I'll probably get it for my 3DS, just the 3DS I own. I own the traditional, not even the XL 3DS. I'll probably end up getting it on that. But I don't know about grabbing a new 3DS just for
you. Don't have an XL, you must have better vision than I do.
2020, baby.
I think they're making it kind of dumb, because the Smash Brothers version that's coming out with the emblem on it, that's the one you're talking about, right, Brian?
Yeah. It's like red and has black and white logo on it.
Yeah, that's not gonna be with a C stick. But you need the C stick.
Yeah, it's gonna be a 3DS, not a new 3DS.
Backwards.
Hold on.
The game's coming out before the new 3DS.
Yeah, but a lot of people are going to be jumping on the new 3DS for Smash Brothers because of the C stick. You know what I'm saying?
Why would you need the C stick for Smash Brothers?
To dodge. Everyone uses it to dodge.
No, you don't use the C stick to do that. Well, I guess the easy way, I guess.
Yeah. That's why everyone's gripe about the GameCube controller. The C stick.
And you just hold down black and tap up or down to dodge.
Everyone wants a C-stick.
Yeah, that's the cheat, man. That's how rookies play, man.
That's rank 105 type shit.
Come on, that's rookie move. Rank 105 cheating ass.
Uh-huh. All right, anybody got any more news they want to talk about? There's not a whole lot this week.
What'd you guys think about
DC Thoughts episode 38, guys?
What'd you guys think about the whole Destiny thing? The Sony having rights for their commercials?
Yeah.
Oh, that was a funny thing for Microsoft to do. That was a funny ad.
Have you smelled our new Destiny?
Yeah. Like with so it was a perfume bottle. In case anybody hasn't seen it, they had a perfume bottle, and it said Destiny on it, and then at the very bottom it had a little Xbox logo. And then if you click through, you know, it said, we're not allowed to advertise Destiny the video game, so we did this as kind of a, you know, a jokey kind of thing. And it was funny. I thought it was really good. In fact, if I saw one of those bottles at Kmart, I would buy one.
Yeah, but the thing...
Oh, shit.
The thing is, at the end of this ad, it says, thanks for smelling that there was something up. It feels kind of like Microsoft was a little upset that Sony was advertising for Destiny, and... See, Sony could do the same thing with Call of Duty and make some Call of Duty fragrance, but you know, this is a company, Microsoft, they do this all the time. They pay third parties for exclusive
content. So you're mad. You sound mad.
No, I'm not mad at all. I'm just saying they seem mad. They seem mad to actually have to make this ad and even say anything about it, because just look at the facts. Destiny's, got exclusive content on PlayStation.
Yeah.
Call of Duty has exclusive content on Xbox.
Yeah.
But you don't see Sony coming out and, you know, getting upset because they have exclusive period of time that they could advertise the game.
Yeah.
It's just business. And so Microsoft, it seems like even...
But if they had thought of an advertisement this good, they would have done it. Especially the Sony
especially the Sony
of last year's E3 and on, because Sony has been out there doing some funny stuff in the press. You know, like talking about how to share games. You hand a copy of the game over to your buddy. You remember that YouTube video last summer?
Oh yeah.
Stuff like that. So let's not say Sony is beyond this kind of advertising. They would definitely do it if they thought about it. I thought it was really inventive. And it also did get the message out there. Hey, you know, Destiny is on the Xbox One too. It got the message out, you know.
I don't know. I think it's bullshit either way for either console to have exclusive marketing rights, exclusive DLC, all that stuff is asinine in my eyes.
It used to be that the consoles differentiated themselves based on first party content.
Yeah.
And that does not seem to be happening anymore. Yeah, Mario and Sonic, that kind of stuff. That just is gone. Those days are over. Even Halo is no longer, you know, I mean, Halo is still a first party thing, but it doesn't nearly have the cachet it used to. I really feel like the companies are relying on these deals too much. It makes me sad.
I mean, I think it's going to continue. It's just the way that this thing is going. Now it's all about money. It's all about business. And, you know, Sony and Microsoft are going to do it. Yeah. Sony and Microsoft are going to do whatever they can to keep consumers on their side through advertising, through exclusive content, through free shit like PlayStation Plus. And it's going to continue. And basically, everybody out here is going to benefit in the end. Microsoft's doing a real good job, though, as well, of pulling people over to their side of the fence. Did you guys hear about this Xbox One free game promotion?
No, I didn't.
Yeah, when you buy the Xbox One, I think this promotion ends on September 15th.
Yeah, you
with
get
an Xbox One, yeah, you get either Call of Duty Ghosts, Watch Dogs, Diablo 3, Titanfall, Plants vs. Zombies, Garden Warfare, or Madden 15.
Wow.
For free.
Those are big games, too.
Yeah, those are not... These are really big games. They're all AAA titles. And
Diablo and Madden are brand new, too.
Brand new. So, I mean, just on that alone, there's a lot of people out there who are big Diablo fans and don't have it on the console, that'd be a great reason to pick up an Xbox.
Yeah.
So, I mean, these companies are just going tit for tat right now. They're trying to one-up the
next. That's exactly what we want as consumers.
I'm
afraid that Sony's going to run away with this thing so far that they get back into that PlayStation 2 mentality where they don't...
Yeah, unstoppable, yeah, unbeatable, do whatever we want.
That scares me a little bit.
They could turn into Nintendo.
Turn into Sony when they were, you know, releasing the PlayStation 3.
Hey, guys, I put a link in the chat. It's all these codes that are given out to Destiny, and you can go on their website and claim all those items right now.
Oh, really?
You just put them in their website and hit redeem code, and it will be on your character when you load the game up.
Jesus!
There's like 17 items. You just do it through Bungie's website.
Where'd they come from?
There's a
level
leak on them. There's a leak on them last week. And people were talking about this list that is going to be announced, and that is the list of them right there. So,
shoot. You're a gentleman and a scholar.
Like, are they limited? Can we just throw them in the chat as well?
Yeah, no. They're for everybody, dude. You can use them for as much as you want. So if you want to link them in the video or whatever, do whatever.
I'll do that. You know what I'll do is I'll put them in the description of the video. And since we're going to continue to record this for another, I don't know, hour and a half, if I forget to do that, somebody remind me in the comments, and I will do it.
I bookmarked it, yeah, so I won't forget.
Because that wouldn't be the first time I said I was going to link something in the description.
All you do is sign up for your Bungie thing, your Bungie account, and on the right side, you click on your name, and then it will say redeem code, and you just... copy and paste all of them.
I'm already in, baby.
That's awesome. That's great news. I love that. I really like the stuff that they announced for the PlayStation 4 exclusives. Now, I know we just talked about how we don't like exclusives, and I totally got called out for this in my video. Like, in the comments, Because I like a week before, I was like making a video about how I was pissed off about how Call of Duty was getting the DLC first for Xbox One. And then the next week, I'm talking about how cool the exclusives look for the PS4.
No, but that is the honest to God truth. If the exclusive stuff is coming to the console you prefer, you're going to be happy about it, you know? But if it's not, you're going to be fucking mad. That's just the way it works.
But they have this one handgun that looks absolutely badass. It's got, like, feathers on it. I don't know. It looks
cool. I saw that one, yeah.
And also for... Do you have Call of Duty Reserve? You also get a code for armor when you pick up the game.
That's right. Yeah.
To let everybody know.
It's not armor. It's like colors for armor. So the armor you have, you can color it.
I thought it was level 20 armor or something like that. It was something weird.
Maybe I'm crazy. I thought it was just colors, but
I don't know. Crazy.
I'm probably.
We all are inside, just at least a little bit, you know.
Have any of you guys preloaded Destiny?
Yes, it's preloaded on my PS4. I'm ready to go. I just gotta wait till midnight tomorrow.
Would you be upset if your clock like stopped at 11:59 and just didn't go to 12?
Or your PS4 just like decided it didn't want to?
I'd just be like, that's
the laws of physics anymore.
Screw this, I'm done. Yeah.
Oh man. Yeah, I'm really excited about Tuesday. I'll be working throughout the whole day.
Yeah.
But when I get home, it's going to be on. I know you guys will all be asleep. You know,
that's a problem. That's why you got to quit that job, like we were talking about last week.
Yeah, my dad told me, I can stay in the shed out back. Bring all the kids. Grab a couple long extension cords and a space heater.
That's the thing, man. You got all those kids. You know, there's got to be some sweatshops near you, right?
Yeah.
just make them all play WoW and start farming shit for you.
That's right. Yeah.
I have my own website up in 2 weeks.
I got to talk to Jan. We're going to have some more kids so I can gold farm.
Yeah. Welcome to BeastlyThoughtsMMO.com. Would you like to buy some gold? Get to work, kids. Yeah. Yeah, but I think in the next couple of weeks and months, it'll be a revolutionary time to be a gamer. There's a lot of stuff going on, and we're reaching that precipice and as far as the way games look and the way they're presented that we've always dreamed about. Now that we're actually here at this moment in time, it's really awesome to me.
I'm hyped.
But we said the same thing about PlayStation 1, though, so it doesn't matter.
I am completely psyched about the games coming out this fall too. And early winter. I mean... I'm a little bit disappointed because there were some games that I was really looking forward to that got delayed. That Tom Clancy game comes to mind.
Yeah.
It doesn't Division. Really come to mind. Yeah, Division.
Division.
Yeah. The Witcher. One that I could never remember the name. Yeah, The Witcher. That would have been nice if it came out this year. But there are some really amazing games that come to mind. And 9to5 just took off. And what I was going to do was say, why don't we... try and select the 5 best games coming out this fall.
Mm.
All right? And we have to agree on one top 5 list.
Okay.
Oh.
Okay.
No, that's bullshit right there. That's the truth.
That's the definitive list.
The definitive list of the 5 most anticipated games coming out between now and 2015.
Okay.
Oh shoot.
So, does anybody want to go first with their top 5? Because I actually contacted everybody but Robbie. Unfortunately, I didn't get a hold of Robbie before the show, but hopefully Robbie's had time enough during the show to come up with his top 5 list. But
I think I got one.
He's gonna go.
Oh, okay.
Go ahead and do your damn thing, brother.
All right. So, I think number 5, I would say either. I want to say, like... Okay, you know, I'll just start with number 1. Screw it. Never mind. So my most anticipated would probably be either Destiny or Far Cry 4. No, I'm going to put Far Cry 4 number 2.
Okay.
Advanced Warfare number 3. AC Unity number 4. I'm not sure about 5th. So I got 4 out of 5, but I'm not sure about the fifth one. What else is coming out?
I got mine done. I got mine done already.
All right, what's coming out?
1 Destiny, 2 Far Cry, 3 Bayonetta, 4 Smash Brothers, 5 Sunset Overdrive. That's exactly, I'm not picking racing games because I actually think Forza is going to be good, but I don't think racing games should be considered in game like as a whole because it's their own like strict genre for the most part.
So your number 1 was Destiny, your 2 was, what was it, Far Cry?
Far Cry, yeah.
Far Cry. I'm writing these down. 3 was what?
Bayonetta. Bayonetta 2, yeah. 4 is Smash Brothers. And 5 is Sunset Overdrive. I would pick Assassin's Creed in there somewhere, but it looks too much of the same, and that's what bothers me about Assassin's Creed, is it's fucking boring.
Tell me how you really feel, 9-to-5. Shit.
Chalk that up with Watch Dogs, too, man.
Oh, good shit, yeah.
Absolutely. Okay, I think I got it. So number 1 would be Destiny, number 2, Far Cry 4, 3 would be Advanced Warfare,
yeah.
4 would be Ace to Unity, and 5 would probably be Sunset Overdrive. Yeah.
Sunset Overdrive.
There you go.
That was your number 5 too, right, 9-to-5?
Yeah, I think that game's going to be really good.
It looks good. It looks promising.
All right.
Okay, this is the BC Gamer Top 5 most anticipated games of 2014.
You better, just real quick, you better not put Drive Club in there. I'm just going to put that out there. Drive Club better not be on your list. Little Big Planet can be on your list, though. I'll give you that.
Oh, get the hell out of here, man. Even though I like Minecraft, Little Big Planet, that's Kate. My number 1 is going to be Destiny. I'm super excited about that. I think that game has a tail that's going to spin around for years.
I hope so. 2, I hope you're right about that.
I think that game is going to last for a long time. Yep. Number 2 is the new Super Smash Bros. 5 for the Wii U. Number 3 is Bloodborne.
Bloodborne doesn't come out this year.
Yes, it does.
No, it doesn't. February.
They did. Damn, they pushed it back. Well, I got my top 4.
All right.
Call of Duty Advanced Warfare. That could be my number 3. The Evil Within, number 4. And let me think.
I'm worried about Evil Within, just to put it out there real quick.
I'm kind of a little worried about it myself. I'll go ahead and say Sunset Overdrive for 5.
Oh, really? You don't even have an Xbox One. You're going with an Xbox One game.
What? It looks very fun, and the developer has...
It's supposed to be a Sony game.
The developer has a long history of making really fun games with the Sony platform, so I don't think they're going to change that just because it's on another platform.
I love their Ratchet and Clank games. I thought they were fantastic.
Is Evolve this year?
No.
Okay.
That would have been on my list.
Yeah, that was originally supposed to come out like around now. I almost want to say like late August when they were talking about it, which would have been perfect for that game. All right. My number 5 is going to be Sunset Overdrive.
Wow, we all agree.
Yeah, everybody put that as their number 5 too. So that one should be easy. Number 4, nobody else mentioned this game. I'm surprised about that. Middle Earth: Shadow of Mordor. I'm really actually looking forward to that game, but I'm a Lord of the Rings fan, so that might have something to do with that.
I think it's going to be good, but from all the cutscenes I've seen, I'm like, I don't know about it, man. It's like the animations are very robotic looking.
Really?
Yeah.
All right, next is going to be another game nobody else mentioned. It was Dragon Age Inquisition. That didn't get moved, right? That's still November.
Oh, yeah. You're right. That'll be up there. That'll be up there for sure. That's like contention of game of the year type shit.
And then
they go back to the original strategy and not make it like Dragon Age 2.
Yeah. Well, we can hope. I mean, it looks good, so I'm going to hope that it is good. My number 2, I'm actually surprised about, but it's Call of Duty Advanced Warfare. The only reason this is my number 2 and not my number 1 is because of Destiny and the fact that it's a kangaroo shooter. But yeah, number 1 is Destiny. I think, does everybody agree on that one too?
Absolutely.
No.
Yeah,
Destiny's got
to be number
Destiny
1.
Destiny is 1, okay.
You got Destiny is 1, right, Beastly?
Yeah, Destiny is my number 1. I'm going to change my number 5.
Whoa!
We're starting to get last a build going
here. I'm just keeping it real. I'm keeping it real now. I would rather play Dragon Age than play Sunset Overdrive.
I'd have to almost agree with you on that one.
I would.
Yeah.
I mean, watching Sunset Overdrive, it looks like a lot of fun. It's fast paced, but I feel like I've already seen everything almost. Of course, the characters are very customizable, but the way the game is played, it's like if you watch Jet Grind Radio and you see 30 minutes of that, that's the whole game. We'll see.
Those guys are pretty talented developers.
I think the amount of game that Dragon Age is going to give you is going to be a whole lot more than Sunset Overdrive, which is going to give it longevity.
Yeah, I would agree with that.
So swap that for me, Mr. Rabbit, and now we can decide who has the definitive list.
Well, we're going to have to agree on one. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go through all the games that we put on our list. The games that we have, the first one, our number one, seems like it's obvious, right? Everybody's looking forward to Destiny the most. So I'm just going to put that one as our number one right away. I'm shocked. I didn't think it would be that easy to make our number one. I really am. I thought like Far Cry or Dragon Age or Sunset Overdrive or something would at least compete with it. But number two, I think, is going to be more of an issue because that is different with just about everybody. Robbie had Far Cry. I had Far Cry. Beastly had New Super Smash Brothers, and I had Advanced Warfare. Everybody had Advanced Warfare on their list except for 9 to 5 Gamers.
Of course I didn't. I'm kidding. I don't think it's good. I don't like Call of Duty. But I will get good at this one because I have to, because Battlefield's not coming out. So
yeah,
I have to be a beast at this one. So prepare to get raped, people. I'm just saying. All
right, other games that were on the list, Far Cry. We saw a couple of times. Bayonetta, we only saw once. Smash Brothers made a couple of appearances. Assassin's Creed Unity. Sunset Overdrive, I think I already said. Smash Brothers, Evil Within made one appearance. And Dragon Age is on a couple. So, those are the list of games we have to work with. It's not a big list of games. I'm surprised it's as narrow as it is. Maybe we need to get some more hosts on here.
I got to hear Not Too Nerdy's top five, too.
Yeah, it's too bad he's not here.
He always sprinkles in something a little bit different, so we'll hear from him next week.
All right, so what do you guys think the list should be, 1 through 5? I'm kind of thinking that Far Cry, Advanced Warfare, and Sunset Overdrive all need to be on there.
Well, that's picking 4 out of the 5, so that's not really... are we going to pick someone's list?
No, we have to agree on a list. We just have to make a list.
Shit.
Smash Brothers got to be on there, man.
No.
Yeah, it does. No. Yes, it does.
Yes, it does.
It's going to win Fighter of the Year, and it's going to be... Adult friends.
Smash Brothers.
No, it's got online, dude, and it's going to have chat. It's going to fucking...
Same damn game it's always been. No.
Hey, Robbie. Don't you go there, Robbie. Don't even go there.
I just went there, BC. I went there already.
All right, I'll put Smash Brothers tentatively at number 5, but I'm not looking forward to that game at all.
I don't know.
That's crazy. It's crazy that they ain't looking forward to Smash Brothers, man.
I know.
That's going to be like one of the best games of the year.
Not only is it going to sell more consoles. Oh, dude, you know what game isn't on there that haven't picked? Halo Master Chief Collection Edition.
Yeah.
Oh, well.
That's crazy.
I'm sorry. That should be on there just for the amount of shit you get for your money.
Value. you get more old games than for any other $60 game.
and you get 120 maps, and they're all redone, and you can play all the campaigns. I'm sorry, dude.
Are they all redone?
Yeah, they're all redone.
They're all 60 frames per second, 1080p, but the
added textures
Halo 2.
And shadows.
Yeah, but the maps from Halo 2 are the 6 maps that have been totally redone.
Okay. Mm-hmm. All right. Dragon Age. Do you think it makes the list here?
Yeah.
Just I think it should for the content. On there. Yep, I agree. I agree with you, Beastly.
All right, above or below Smash Brothers?
Ooh, below. Below Smash.
No, above. No, above.
I got to say above.
Yeah.
Hey, it's 2 versus 2. We need somebody to weigh in, okay?
All right, I'm going to put it on there.
To me, I say below easy.
Together as a whole, we're older than you guys, so.
Yeah.
Oh, whatever. Don't even talk about my age, okay?
Don't even go there.
That's not fair.
All right, Advanced Warfare. Above or below Smash Brothers?
Oh, fuck, above by a mile.
Yeah, below. I'm going to say above.
Below.
What?
Crazy. Below.
Are you guys going to put Smash Brothers as the number two? Is that what you're aiming for?
No, I would say three.
It's number three. Below Far Cry.
Below Far Cry or maybe even Dragon Age, for that matter.
Far Cry above Advanced Warfare?
Hell yeah.
No, Advanced Warfare. Yeah. I think Advanced Warfare would be better than Far Cry this year.
I honestly had trouble picking between Far Cry and Advanced Warfare. I was debating which was number two and number three, so it doesn't matter to me.
We really do need Not Too Nerdy here, because we're going to get hung up on, like, every one of these.
And you know what? Not Too Nerdy would say this. This list sounds good, but one thing you guys didn't think about, and then all of a sudden he'll blow our whole list away.
Yeah, right?
That's true. That's what we're missing right now.
All right, Sunset Overdrive. Is it making the list?
No.
Yeah.
Robbie, you say yeah? 9 to 5, what do you say?
Shit. What do we have at number 5? What'd you say is number 5 right now?
I haven't ranked them. But so right now we have 4 games.
We have 1 right now,
right? We can, because Destiny's number 1 for sure.
Okay,
Destiny's number 1.
And then we have Advanced Warfare, Dragon Age, and Smash Brothers all on the list, but not...
Smash Brothers is number 2 out of those.
No, shit, no.
Yes.
Sorry, no.
If you want to take Sunset Overdrive off, I agree with Smash Brothers being 2.
Yeah, Smash Brothers number 2.
Not only is it going to sell more copies, but it's going to sell fucking consoles.
Yeah, it's going to move consoles like code, baby.
Systems like yeah, like...
Yeah, it's going to fucking move them. I'm serious, so, okay.
Sunset Overdrive, I want on that list, though. I want it more than AC Unity.
Yeah, Assassin's Creed.
I agree with that all day. Fuck Assassin's Creed.
Assassin's Creed sucks.
I will be picking it up, but it's going to feel like a rainy day when I have to dust it off.
I'm messing with Robbie.
I don't really care, honestly. It's not like I'm dying to get Assassin's Creed. Like, I think it looks really good, but I'm not going to like cry over it. All
right.
Okay, so.
Assassin's Creed's not making the list. Bayonetta, I don't think that's making the list.
Me neither.
It's all right, haters.
It's all good.
Evil Within, I don't think is making the list.
Okay.
Yeah, that's not for sure.
Because it's too much of a question. It could end up being awesome, and it could end up sucking. So just on that premise alone, I'll let it go.
Yep, and I think the same thing of Shadows of Mordor. Evil Within. It could be amazing, and it could be a flop.
No, this game is going to be fantastic, I'm telling you. It's got, like, Batman fighting.
If the day it comes out, if it's good, I'm picking it up that day.
It's got the Nemesis system, man, the Nemesis system!
Man, he's passionate as hell. Let him keep his game, man.
just keep it in, for God's sake.
Who's making that? Ubisoft?
Oh, no. I hope not.
Is that who's making it?
That's Monolith. They're making it.
It's going to be Assassin's Creed with a skin on it, man. Watch. Hold up.
They already said it is. They already said the way he moves is just like Assassin's Creed.
Yeah, and I hate that shit.
Oh.
All right.
Of Mordor.
So nobody went with any PC game. Civilization Beyond Earth didn't make the cut for anybody.
No.
Half-Life 2, you know? Or Half-Life 3 is not... who's making this?
Half-Life 3? Half-Life 3 just announced! Breaking news!
Yeah, I wish.
No,
you're good. You're good. Warner Brothers is making it, so it might be actually really decent.
All right, so I will agree that's probably got to drop because I'm the only one who put it on my list. So that, by definition, means it's only anticipated by a quarter of the population of the Beastly Thought Show.
Mm-hmm. And I guarantee you, if Not Too Nerdy was here, Smash Bros. Would be 2. Here's the thing about Smash Bros.
Even though me and Robbie aren't looking forward to it, the amount of anticipation for that game
is fucking amazing.
Stunning. Like, it's absolutely off the wall.
Yeah.
Would you guys put that as your number 2?
Yeah.
I already said
I'd have Smash as number 2. Yeah.
You think that's more hotly anticipated than Advanced Warfare?
Yes.
No.
Yes.
Yes. By the population at large, you really think?
Because, you know what? A lot of people are still going to be on the Destiny boat. A lot of people, by the time Call of Duty comes out, they're still going to be on the Destiny boat, and they're going to be playing that as their first-person shooter.
That's right, and that's not coming to the Wii U or the 3DS. Yep. Those people have to sit there and wait for Nintendo games to come out once every 6 months.
Well, they have one every year next year. They have a game coming out every year next year.
Every month
next year.
Everybody who has a Nintendo console is going to be looking forward to Smash in some way or another, be it on 3DS or the Wii U.
I have the Nintendo consoles, and I'm not looking forward to it.
You don't play it. Those are for the kids.
That's true. They are for the kids.
Here's what I'll say about Smash Bros. I'm excited about it, only to play it with you guys, but that's about it. That's really just it. I'm not that excited about it.
Yeah, I can see some funny YouTube videos being made of Beastly.
Yeah. Oh, hell yeah. Somebody
like me coming up for some ridiculous term for something that Beastly's doing to me over and over again while I'm bent over. That video is going to get made. I don't know, man. Smash Brothers or Advanced Warfare? I think I got to give it to you guys. What do you think, Robbie? Should we let them have this one and fight our fight on the next one?
No, Smash Brothers isn't going any higher than 5. Hey, I refuse. It's the same game it's always been. That's not cool.
You're lucky. You're lucky Call of Duty's even on the list in my
eyes.
talk about being the same damn thing, man.
Call of Duty is changing up this year. You better believe it.
It's the same damn game with jetpacks. It's the same damn thing. It will be the same damn thing. They're like, hey, we're bringing back Semtex.
Yeah, I think we can move to number 3. I think Smash should sit comfortably there.
Yeah, Robbie, I got to go with him just because it's so anticipated. I mean, I don't care about it, really.
I don't either.
But, like...
Just do it. Fine.
All right, I'm doing it. I'm moving it to number 2.
I'll revisit
it, though.
Sobbing a little bit.
If I can come up with a good argument, we'll revisit
it. Call of Duty 3, right?
Definitely. I mean, okay. It can't be lower than 3.
Okay.
I think so.
And then the only thing we got to decide about
since you gave me Smash Brothers
is Dragon Age and Sunset Overdrive. Who's 4 and who's 5?
Dragon Age is number 4.
Sunset Overdrive is 5.
I completely disagree with you guys.
Why?
Sunset Overdrive is a brand new game by the developer Ratchet and Clank. It's the first time this developer has been on the Xbox, so those guys are super excited. Agreed, there's only about 2 million Xbox Ones out there compared to...
Briar, think about this. Think about this real quick. Yeah. Dragon Age is going to be Shadows of Mordor. Like, what you want Shadows of Mordor to be, that's going to be Dragon Age.
Yeah, good point.
If Dragon Age...
And Dragon Age is going
to
have...
It's just as good as Dragon Age 1. That's all I want it to be. I just want it to be that game with a new story, basically.
Yeah, that game was really good. Yeah, it 1 was really amazing. Good.
It's like Resident Evil, how Capcom has taken Resident Evil and rebooting it, taking it back to the scary aspect of it. When Dragon Age 2 came out, there was a lot of public outcry about how people did not like what they did with the game. They took it away from the RPG elements and added more of this action-centric gameplay, and people just didn't like it. So after all that public outcry, I'm pretty sure that with this new Dragon Age, they're going to go back to the drawing board, give us what we loved about the original game.
I hear what you're saying, Beastly, but the problem is that Dragon Age 2 sold like gangbusters, and they got this whole new group of fans who liked the way that game played. So what the fuck do they do?
Kind of the same thing that happened with the Mass Effect 2. Mass Effect did the same thing.
Yeah, and then Mass Effect 3 ended up being more Mass Effect 2.
With a terrible ending. Yeah. Worst ending ever.
All right, so here's the list as it stands right now. Number 5, Dragon Age. Number 4, Sunset Overdrive. Number 3, Smash Brothers. Number 2, Advanced Warfare. And number 1, Destiny.
No.
One thing you
everybody in agreement here?
It sounded great. It sounds perfect as it is, except for Smash Brothers, but whatever, we can't change that.
He pulled the bitch bomb switcheroo on us.
Yeah, he sure did. Shit.
The bitch bomb switcheroo. Alright, for real. I really think it's over Dragon Age. I really do.
I like Sunset Overdrive because it's new, it's different. The art is going to be phenomenal in it. Like, when stuff explodes, it turns into a cartoon and all types of shit like that. And when you come in, respawn, you're coming out of, like, a telephone booth. I think all that is awesome.
Yeah, and it's a new game by the guys who made Ratchet & Clank.
I think I'm going to beat the game in a week. Like, no lie. I think
it's going to be a fairly short experience. I agree.
Yep.
I feel like, just from what we've seen, you've seen the mechanics of the game, and it's like not much more than that's going to be in the game.
Robbie, it's up to you here.
Yeah.
Where do you want to go? Dragon Age or Sunset Overdrive?
Probably Dragon Age. Just gonna have more legs, so I'm going to say Dragon Age.
I hate all of you.
Yes.
Everyone.
Yes. I don't really care which one it is, but like, I don't care which one it is. So it's fine. Sunset Overdrive.
No, you can't do that.
You can't give someone who he doesn't care. He just committed video game suicide. He doesn't.
Great. That's all I think. I don't 4 or 5, whatever.
I'll flip a coin.
All right. I believe this is our final list. Number 5, Sunset Overdrive, because you guys are assholes.
Of course.
Number 4, Dragon Age. For the previously stated reason. Number 3, Advanced Warfare, but that's just because Beastly and 9 to 5 are assholes. Number 2, assholes. Smash Brothers.
Okay, no.
Yes.
But number one, I think everybody can agree on Destiny. This would be a lot harder to make next week. We probably should have waited to make it next week. Because everybody just went Destiny all the way.
Yeah, and you would have had your hands on Destiny and known more about it.
Yeah, and I would have never said yes to Smash Brothers on number one. I would have fought that tooth and nail. I would have ended the show.
I would have been right.
Done.
Are you going to buy a Smash Brothers bundle if it comes out? Because you got to get on that boat, man. You got to get that ass whooped right.
Me? You fucking crazy. I swear, you crazy right there.
C-Stick, son. C-Stick, 1-1-1-105.
I don't need no C-Stick to whoop that ass on me. No, I'll have mine. I'm actually going to... Kate and I were just out today, and we're making plans to do it probably next week for my Wii U. At least I want to get that ball rolling for that. That's what I want before my Xbox One. I gotta have Smash.
You should wait and see if they do a bundle with Smash though before you get it. Like, give it some time and see, because they're gonna release a bundle that comes to like a GameCube controller. I guarantee.
Yeah.
I guarantee you, and it's probably gonna be a different color. I bet you they're gonna make a red one or something.
Is that coming out the same day for both the 3DS?
No, 3DS comes first.
A lot of people are claiming November for the Wii U version, sometime like the end of November.
They haven't even set a date yet?
No, but you know how Nintendo is. They're going to announce it, and it'll be out in a week.
Well, the 3DS version, they said it was supposed to be out in summer. Summer's pretty much over, so I don't know.
The reason why that got pushed back is because they're putting like 39 characters in the game or something like that. They added like Pac-Man and Sonic and Mega Man and like all these people last minute.
Let me ask you a question. How do you think the 3DS version is going to sell compared to the Wii U version? I think the 3DS version will outsell the Wii U version.
How many 3DSs are out there? 35 million. How many Wii Us are out there?
Yeah,
13?
Yeah, good point.
I've got one. I think 9 to 5 has the other.
There's only 5 million Wii Us out there, I think.
It can't possibly sell as well as the 3DS.
It's selling more than Xbox, I know that. Whatever it is, it's sold more than Xbox. Which is fucking crazy in my eyes.
Another question I want to ask you guys. Destiny in 2 days, anybody using the remote play to play it?
I did with the beta, and it was a real pain in the ass.
Yeah,
remote play is a joke.
Yeah. It should work fine for playing like through Strike or whatever, but the tapping the touchpad on the back of the controller, yeah, I didn't like it.
Yeah.
I just feel like they dropped the ball with the remote play this time around. Even with the PSP, I could be somewhere across town doing remote play to my PlayStation 3.
Yeah. All they had to do was just put the damn R2 buttons on there.
Yeah, but what I'm saying
is, I would have been good with it.
In order to do remote play with the PS Vita and the PS4, you have to be in the same location using local Wi-Fi, but you can't go to another location and play like you can with the PSP. The PSP, I could go to my friend's house or across town, log into their internet, and boot up my PS3 from across town and play my games.
And you have to have a super baller internet connection on top of it.
Yeah.
Yeah, but,
like,
but
for it to run smoothly.
You know, but that's what I'm saying. It worked. It would seem like they would have, you know, revolutionized that and pushed that idea forward rather than just give you the option of playing it locally at home. Sure, my wife likes to watch Lifetime. Sure, she does. But, you know, I should be able to
still. You gotta get rid of her, man.
Yeah, that fucking Lifetime. Saved by the Bell. Who wants to watch Saved by the Bell?
What? What you got against Saved by the Bell?
it's the unauthorized. They made that new movie about him, the actors and crap.
What?
But yeah, it's an unauthorized biography of the actual actors. It's like they hired a bunch of kids who look like him, and they're telling the real story about Screech banged all the girls and stuff.
Screech lives on my fucking in my city. He's trying to sell T-shirts to pay off his house.
Damn.
Like, for real, he lives, like, in Milwaukee. Like, he's always at the Rave and everything else, man. Like, the Rave is, like, a big theater where concerts go. Every time you go there, he's there. Like, get a life, dude.
Damn. He told
me. That sounds like a good life to me. If he's at every concert at his town.
No, but he's, like, he's broke. He's super broke.
I thought he was doing porn or something. Is that just an urban legend?
He did that already.
Huh.
He should do porn. He'd be paying off his house.
So you're telling me that this guy has pretty much lived my dream life.
Yeah.
He was a child actor, did porn. Now he sells t-shirts and costumes.
Raves. Fuck.
He's pretty much worked out my 10-year plan.
That's my bucket list right there in 5 years.
All right, anybody got anything else they want to talk about today? I really didn't come with the news this week, guys. I apologize.
No, the news
was that whole was the whole Destiny thing.
Yeah, Destiny is huge. What specifically?
Just the whole cologne thing. That was funny. That was hilarious.
That was good. I liked it.
No, I think the biggest Destiny news period was pre-ordering on the last gen consoles and getting the free upgrade.
Yeah.
That's ridiculous, and it's for everybody. I mean, to me, that was like a flare went off in the sky. I mean, never seen something like that before, and I think that the game, especially now, it'll have such a huge install base because everybody will have the opportunity to play it.
Yeah.
Everybody.
Yeah, so as people come up to the next-gen consoles, too, or the current-gen consoles, they'll already have played it.
The thing is, the way they worked it out, it's benefiting everyone so much because, you know, there's thousands of kids across the country who don't have a PS4 or an Xbox One who will be getting one for Christmas this year.
Yeah.
And so if their mom or dad buys them Destiny now and they get it the digital version, they'll get a free upgrade when they get the new stuff.
Yes.
Yeah. That's unbelievable. That's unheard of. And a game like Destiny 2 on top of it, that's huge news. And yeah, Microsoft did pretty good with the Destiny cologne. Can you smell my Destiny? Yeah, it's been kind of a slow week on the news front. I think that was predominantly the heavy hitters this week. There's been some smaller things out there, but I'm sure many of our viewers have already seen that other stuff.
Yeah.
Do we have an insane question this week?
No.
another thing real quick.
Go ahead.
Destiny doing the whole, like, where if you buy the old version and you get the new version. The old version, and you get like the next gen version of the copy of the game. If you do that, that's showing that your game is going to have longevity too. You know what I'm saying? If they're that confident to be like, hey, if you buy the next gen system, you're going to get this for free. That's saying a lot.
That's everybody's big question about this game at this point, right? Yep. It's like, I know I'm going to love it for a week. I know I'm probably going to love it for 2 weeks. Hopefully, it'll last a month because I'm doing, you know, the raids with my friends, like those high-level raids. But am I really going to be playing this game for, you know, 3 months, 6 months, a year? Is that really going to be happening? Am I still going to be playing Destiny when Destiny 2 comes out? That's my question. Oh. You know, I have no idea what the answer to that question is.
I don't think there'll be a Destiny 2 for quite a long time. I'm talking about they have a 10-year plan for this game. If they do make a Destiny 2.
They have a 10-year plan for the franchise, not for this game.
Well, the fact this is an MMO, essentially, it's a first-person MMO, they're going to be constantly adding to the game. It's not like, you know, content's going to run out. They're going to have updates and patches, constantly adding new places, new planets, and so there really won't be a need for a part two for a very long time, because it's essentially an MMO. You know, it's where a lot of people get together and play the game and enjoy the experience together. And if you ask me, they're going to take an MMO stance on the way that they upgrade the game by adding new planets, adding new territories, adding new modes years to come.
I don't feel that way, though. I don't feel it's going to be like that. I feel that they're going to microtransact the shit out of this game. It's going to be MMO, but you're going to have to buy everything. I almost guarantee you that. I wish I could say differently, but I don't think it's going to be that way.
Kind of like World of Warcraft, when they create a whole new territory and you buy that expansion.
That's fine. That's how expansions work.
Yes, I agree if it's the content. Like, because to be honest with you, I don't care about the multiplayer in Destiny. I don't think I ever will.
Uh-huh.
I want more content in the campaign. I want more places to go see with my friends and play co-op. That's what I want more than multiplayer ever. Don't give me multiplayer content, because I don't want it.
I love them both. And so don't listen to 9to5. I think that the Crucible is fun as hell. And I enjoy the single-player / multiplayer campaign aspect of the game. I think they both scratch an itch. And I guess it depends on the type of gamer you are, but the thing is, it's all in one game.
Multiplayer is my ass itch.
Well, I know Briar and I, Oxy30, and Robbie, we all had a great time playing the multiplayer, and we had a great time playing the campaign. I just think it all worked together so well.
It's super fun playing with, like, a team that is all your boys, you know what I'm saying? But playing online by yourself, I can't see myself doing that ever.
That's true for every game, too. It's like, you can play... I saw these guys playing a game where you literally stack these half-naked guys up. Like, that's all you do, is you just kind of, like, you maneuver them, so you're just trying to stack them higher and higher and higher.
What game is this?
It's a Flash game on Pornhub.
It was a four-player game, and they're literally, like, you're just... It's trying to play, like, barrel
naked
of monkeys backward.
Man stacking.
I know what game you're talking about. I don't know what it's called, though.
I can't remember what it's called. Anyway.
I'm on Google.
The thing is, when you get a bunch of friends that you like hanging out with, every game is fun. Is the Crucible going to be fun for months and months and months? You know, is it going to be something like I do with Call of Duty, where I play Call of Duty multiplayer nearly every day all year long, because, you know, I just like getting better and better and better at it. I like having the competition. You know,
it's called Mount Your Friends.
Yeah. Of course.
Really?
It is.
Really? That's the name of that shit? Really? Holy shit, bro. What the hell are you playing it for?
I haven't played it. It's a PC only game, because they wouldn't allow that shit on a Macintosh.
Jesus. Mount Your Friends.
But if they did,
I would play it.
That's so stupid.
Yeah, so I don't know. I am inclined to think that Beastie Gamer is right here, because I had a ton of fun in the Crucible when I was playing with it. But 90% of the time I put into it, like 9to5 says, is I put into it with friends. So,
and another thing, let me bring up another thing. The higher you rank up, the cooler the Crucible will get. You know what I'm saying? So the Crucible we saw playing the beta and the alpha and all that stuff, it's not the same as what it's going to be when we're all 20s and beasts, you know? Because then it's going to open up a whole other type of battle.
Yeah, that's true.
Wow, that's fantastic.
I might enjoy it more.
Something that the weapons you bring in keep their stats.
Yeah.
That I find compelling. I think that's a lot of fun, you know, because if I find some really piece of gear or really cool piece of gear, I'm going to want to bring that in there and start murking people with it, because that makes me smile.
Speaking of the game that you play the most, the game you play every day, Call of Duty Ghosts, I haven't played that in a while. I played a little bit last week, but if anybody wants to play today, I'll play after the show. So.
Okay, I might be able to do that. I'm not sure what my dinner situation is like.
Well, we already know what 9to5 is.
Yeah.
I'll be served in 20 minutes. Oh, man.
So, should we end the show early? We don't have a whole lot of stuff to talk about tonight. Anybody got anything else they want to bring up?
Did everybody see my Last of Us PS4?
Yeah, I did. I thought that was cool.
Yeah, it makes me feel good about myself.
I liked I like Not Too Nerdy's comment that it was on backward.
Yeah, I was laughing my ass off when I saw that.
You got it, makes you feel,
it just makes me feel better when I drop bitch bombs. And see my Last of Us PS4.
Do you have a? Is the controller got the skin on it too?
Yeah.
Yeah.
See.
Yeah,
that's pretty cool.
What kind of grips do you have on that?
These are magnums. They came with my
magnums. Really? That's what I'm gonna start calling mine too, I think.
These are magnums.
Magnum grips, yeah.
The Destiny street date's already been broken. There's people selling it already, so.
Yeah, but I'd be really concerned about getting on Xbox Live and playing it.
Yeah, because they're gonna ban your shit fast.
Yeah. So I wouldn't recommend jumping on that. You know, it comes out. You'll be able to play it midnight on Monday. So.
Oh, I got a good question. To end the show on.
Yeah, go show. Go for it.
It came to me like a thief in the night. if we could only have one first person shooter game out of the games that are coming out this year.
Yeah.
Not next year.
Yeah.
Which would be not Heartland anymore, but I guess it would be Destiny, Call of Duty Advanced Warfare. You could pick one and keep that one forever, but never play the other. Which one would you pick?
So we're going with Destiny and Advanced Warfare.
Yeah. That's a hard one.
I think this would be an easy question because everybody picked this game as their number one.
Yeah,
but if I can only play these games for the next year.
9 to 5, you don't have to answer.
I play Call of Duty all year. I play Call of Duty until the next Call of Duty comes out because that's just I like it, you know? Mm-hmm. This Call of Duty I'm scared about, though.
Yeah, I know. Everybody is. I mean, if we had a little bit more faith in what Call of Duty has been doing in the last few iterations of the game, it would have been the number one on the list. You know, Call of Duty's always been up there, a staple as far as first-person shooter games go.
I was excited for Ghosts when it was coming out. I mean, what I saw in Ghosts, I really was enjoying.
If Rainbow Six was coming out this year, I'd have something else to say. But
I think everybody would.
Or the Division.
The Division. If the Division was coming out this year, that'd probably be my most anticipated game of the year.
Yeah, I agree. Next year is going to be crazy because you have that, Uncharted, the new Halo game, the new Zelda game, like Batman. Yeah, no shit. Witcher, it's going to be crazy as fuck next year.
Insane.
Does anybody have an answer for this? I mean,
what about you? Robbie, what do you think?
Destiny, all the way, Destiny.
Destiny.
Destiny all the way, because it's, I don't know, I think it's going to give me personally, it's giving me more, because I want more of a campaign, co-op campaign. I prefer that over a multiplayer shooter any fucking day.
Mm-hmm.
I'm over the multiplayer shooter. I've been over it for like the last 5 years. Like really, unless you do something different and you're bringing something different to the table, I'm over you, really. I'll play you for a month and you'll be collecting dust, pretty much. I like Battlefield a lot.
But Battlefield doesn't really revolutionize itself either, though.
No. But at the same time, I was going to say, I'm a Battlefield fan, so I'm going to like any Battlefield that comes out. You know what I'm saying? You're gonna be biased towards that no matter what.
Mm-hmm. I've liked Call of Duty over Battlefield every time they've ever come out in close succession, every time.
Is it because you're good at Call of Duty and you suck at Battlefield? I'm not saying you're bad at it. I'm saying that a lot of people
I don't play the game enough. I don't play the game enough to warrant any kind of accolades as far as being a good Battlefield player. It's just when I played both experiences, Call of Duty was more easily accessible for me, and it was easier for me to get into it, and the perks and all these things were easy for me to understand. Battlefield, you got to go into these sub menus and do all this crazy stuff, changing weapons and all these different menus. Call of Duty it presented itself to me as something I could get into easier, and I got into it and I enjoyed it more. Go ahead.
This is a perfect explanation of this. The Call of Duty is an Apple phone, and Battlefield is an Android phone. That is exactly how it is.
That's why Battlefield doesn't work in
it's worked for like the last month and a half.
Oh shit. Well, I got Android. I love Android. I can't mess with Apple. That's the thing. But, yeah, I understand what you're saying. I guess to each his own. But if I had to pick one, I at this point, seeing from what we've seen with both games, I'd pick Destiny. And the reason is because I think that Destiny is going to evolve. It won't just add new weapons or new perks or new skins. I think the actual game is going to evolve. There will actually be new sections of the game that are brought out over the coming months and years that they'll actually change fundamentally what the game is all about. It won't just be, you know, an extra map, you know, for multiplayer or a map pack. It'll actually be campaign missions that you get, new worlds to explore, new armors and weapons, and it'll just be the evolution of the game. And I don't know if Call of Duty will do that this year, but throughout the history of the franchise, all you ever get is multiplayer maps, new weapons, and new skins. So I go with Destiny because you can play with your friends in multiplayer. On competitive multiplayer and the campaign. And to me, that's just more enjoyable than just competitive multiplayer all the time.
I got a question to ask all you guys once you guys are done. I got a question, and I'm saving it. So go ahead.
If I was answering this question last year in the lead up to Ghost, because I was really excited about Ghost, and I'm really excited about Destiny, it would have been easier for me. I would have gone with Ghost because I know that I'm going to be playing Ghost for a year. Advanced Warfare, I'm just not sure. There's so many questions I have. Are they going to be able to adapt the level design to be fun and fast-paced with all this jumping around? You know, are the weapons going to be balanced? Or are they going to be completely OP with these supply drops? Are they going to use supply drops to do micro DLC or, you know, microtransactions? I'm really scared about that. You know, is this going to be where Call of Duty really goes off that cliff of pay to win? I'm not sure. It almost appears that way. But Destiny's got me scared, too, because, you know, yeah, I know I'm going to love Destiny for a month, you know, but am I going to love it for a year? You know, is it going to be the game that I go to in those slow spots when there's not a new release, you know? Like, especially in the summertime. I play Call of Duty all summer. But I can always go back and play old Call of Duties. I can play Black Ops 2. I can play Call of Duty Ghosts. I can play Black Ops 1. I can play Modern Warfare 3. So I'm going to go with Destiny because I can always play the old Call of Duties.
Ah, oh, good answer. Smart answer. Well thought out. He came over that.
Robbie, what's up, Robbie?
Yeah, I've been just sitting here again, you know? But
no, you're go. What do you think?
So here's how I'm going to do this. The top three I'm trying to decide between would be Destiny, Advanced Warfare, and Far Cry 4.
Oh, so nobody even brought up Far Cry.
My problem with
Far Cry is when there's no multiplayer, there's an end to a game. You know what I'm saying? Like, you don't have that drive to play it.
I'll be right back. Kinda,
he's got
to
poop.
Great. let's hope everything comes out. That's a great point. It's an excellent point there, 9 to 5. Kind of like, even though it's not a first-person shooter, Infamous Second Son. You beat the game, there's no multiplayer, there's no reason to get back into it.
Yep. Just like when I platinum the game, as soon as I was done with it, I traded it in. Because it's like, why be on my shelf, you know?
Good point. I mean, does that matter at all to you, Robbie, that the competitive multiplayer and a first-person shooter?
Well, here's how I'm going to look at this. So, when I think of Far Cry 4, yes, it doesn't... Well, I don't think it has multiplayer. Yeah, it's just the cooperative and the campaign, but I think if it's this huge, expansive open world, it's going to be tons of fun to hunt animals and take over outposts and all that, but eventually it's going to have an end. That's a good point, though, yeah. And eventually it's going to have an end to it, so I probably wouldn't pick Far Cry. So when I think about Advanced Warfare, especially compared to any other Call of Duty game, that's going to be a game you can play for months and months and months, maybe even a year until the next game comes out. But then I also think about Destiny. That's got a huge, expansive, open-world campaign where you explore the galaxy, so that could potentially last a long time, too, as well as Crucible. So, it's kind of tough to choose, because they're all such huge games, like, that can last such a long time. But I think I'm going to go with Advanced Warfare, just because I know the multiplayer will probably last for a long time. So, that's my choice.
Well, that's respectable.
Yeah.
See, we didn't say you were full of shit. or anything like that. We agree to disagree there, buddy.
We just know Smash Brothers is going to be better than it, that's all.
Yeah, man. What's wrong with you dudes? I want everybody who's watching this podcast to sign off in the comment section below on your thoughts on Smash Brothers for the Wii U. I think the game's going to be sick. I think it's going to be probably one of the best fighting games of the year, if not the best fighting game of the year.
Compared to what, Dive Kick? What else came out this year?
Dive Kick?
Like, saying it's the best fighting game of the year.
That is funny right there. Dude.
David, you came right into it. Where did you come from? Just all of a sudden coming with that.
It I ain't letting you get away with that shit.
He heard me in the belly from the start.
My question to you guys is do you think Destiny is going to make the mark that Halo did? Do you have a feeling? I'm not talking about pre-orders. I'm not talking about sales. I'm not talking about any of that shit. I'm talking about the multiplayer aspect of it. Do you feel that it's going to make a mark as in the same lines as Halo?
No, I don't.
No, but it's still going to be somewhat of a step. Like, it's still going to be a pretty noticeable, like, bleep on the radar. It's not going to be as huge as something like Halo, but it's going to be still significant in one way or another.
I think it could, and the reason I think it could is we got our hands on a 10-day beta. I didn't get a chance to play the alpha.
And we're like crackheads for it. Like,
yeah.
That's true. You bring up a strong point.
Fuck, I took a vacation day for it.
Everybody lost their minds for Destiny. Everybody had a ton of fun playing it, and we didn't get a chance to see but maybe a 5% of what the game is all about. So I think it could. I think once we actually have the full-fledged copy of the game installed in our systems, we're actually going there and see some of the stuff that's available, things you can do, and how deep the game is. I think it actually could. I mean, for me, Destiny is one of those experiences that you very seldom have playing a multiplayer game. I felt like I was really in like a Star Wars type of environment, and I had my friends with me, and we were doing things together and going to compete, and I just felt... It just felt awesome to me. So, yeah, especially for the new generation. We have memories of Halo. These people who are 18, 19, 20 years old, this is going to be their Halo. This is going to be the new Halo. Yeah. And so, yeah, I think it definitely does have that potential.
I don't know. The thing about Halo was that it revolutionized first-person shooters on console. It was the first time you ever played a first-person shooter on a console that felt right. And Destiny, well, I mean, Bungie brings that legacy with them. It's not that game. It may be the first time you ever play an MMO crossed with a first-person shooter, but I don't know if that's such a big revelation compared to what they did with Halo. Halo was also, for a long time, the only really awesome game on the Xbox.
The only game. Hey, what about Blinks, the time-traveling cat? No, yeah, you're right. But the thing
by default, everybody who bought an Xbox was almost by default a Halo fan.
Halo fan, yeah.
And then the competitive community really kind of embraced it all the way through Halo 3. And I don't know that'll happen with Destiny.
Well, there's only so many ways you can revolutionize the way a video game is played. And, you know, Sony is working on that right now with Morpheus, and Oculus Rift is working on that now with the Oculus. So the only way that a developer can really revolutionize a game is by the experience now. And so this experience to me is so revolutionary that you can get into a competitive multiplayer match with your friends. You're all talking and having a good time destroying another team. And then you say, okay, look, after this match, let's go to another planet and do some missions. And then you seamlessly leave that environment. You don't have to go to all these crazy menus like in other first-person shooter games and seamlessly go and do a mission on a world with, you know, non-player characters, and you run into other people on this planet who are playing the game as well. That's a whole new revolutionary experience to me. And so in my way, I got to say that it is as revolutionary as Halo, but it's just a different type of revolution. But I think it could be just as big, if not bigger, in the eyes of the people who are coming into their own now as gamers, people who are, you know, the first system was the Xbox 360 or, you know, PS3. This game could be what Halo was to all of us when we were teenagers.
So what you're saying is, to the non-OGs, that's what it is.
Triple OG.
OG.
Yeah, that's my thought on it, and I guess only time will tell, but, I mean, seriously, man, all of us, everybody on this show has touted how much fun they had with Destiny. That's one thing that we can all say. It's been one of the most fun experiences we've had this year. This is the game that brought us together more than any other game. We played together more in that little 10-day period than we played together, period, the whole year, okay?
Yeah, but I was talking some shit about Titanfall, man. Yeah. I was amped for Titanfall.
Yeah?
Man.
I think the only person who amped up that game more than you was Ryan McCaffrey on IGN. And he just apologized on a podcast.
Fuck that guy, man.
Yeah, he just came out and apologized for amping that game up for what happened to it. But Destiny, I think it really does deserve those accolades.
That's another question. Do you feel that it has a chance to necessarily be a flop?
Yeah, I do.
You know what I'm saying? Like, what if all the hype and all the bullshit that everyone's been dealing with and reserving the game, it has what the most reserves in GameStop history, right?
Yeah.
What if it ends up being a fucking flop?
It's what not if it ends up being like sales-wise?
No. I mean, like, what if it was like a game 7?
That came out earlier this year that everybody bought, but everybody's like, it was that
Titanfall.
No, it was after that. It was like a Grand Theft Auto kind of thing.
Watch Dogs.
Watch Dogs was like that.
That thing sold like gangbusters, but everybody's opinion on it after buying it was like, it's like Grand Theft Auto, but not quite as good.
I think that this game has less of a chance of that happening because this beta has already shown us kind of what we can expect.
That's true.
And the thing is this, if you compare Titanfall's complete package when it released with the Destiny beta that we played, which one would you have rather picked if you had both? Everybody would have probably picked Destiny over the complete Titanfall.
So you're talking about just the Destiny beta over Titanfall, right?
Yeah.
Because I would just play the Destiny beta over Titanfall.
That's what I'm saying. if they sold us that Destiny beta and said this is a game and maybe added one more level to, you know, the multiplayer, one more level to the actual world, that would have been probably a more fun experience than the full-fledged commercial release of Titanfall. Titanfall isn't even a really commercial fail. The game sold well, it just died down because of a lack of content. There's not enough to keep people interested in the game.
That's my biggest fear with Destiny, too. Yep. Yeah, there's not going to be enough.
But Destiny looks like there's tons of stuff, though. I mean, of course we haven't played it. Yeah, it does. I mean, if you take into account
the whole time I was playing it, I was debating that in my mind. I was debating it the whole time. Like, is this game going to have the drive that I'm going to want?
Because we saw like the whole Earth kind of area. That's all that there's going to be on Earth. There's going to be something like that on Mars, Venus, and
like you said in one of your videos, Briar. Are you going to end up going through the same corridors over and over and over and over and over again? Because that's going to get really fucking boring really fast.
Yeah.
It's going to be a strive to finish that, you know? Like, I don't know.
Well, I think that what we saw in the beta is probably just a small percentage of what's actually going to be in the real world when it's released. The Citadel, all these places are probably going to look different. There'll probably be more locations on each planet. Not to mention all the planets that will be opened up. I mean, we got all these planets in the solar system, but we had our own spot on the moon. That's not even a planet. So, I mean, there's options for them to constantly add to this game.
Yeah.
And I think it's going to be huge, honestly.
But that map area that you saw of Russia, that's all that's going to be on Earth for this game. Like, there's not going to be, like, a same-size map for America or for North America or South America or Africa.
Are you sure of that?
That's no, what they we're
said. Yeah. That's what they confirmed said. It. Yeah, that's what they said. Confirmed it.
The only thing I could say is when you go downstairs in that one area, and you can't go through there, and you can't go through the cave in that one part. There's like the few parts in the beta where you can't go through because you would get murdered, you know.
Yeah, there's some stuff that is just blocked off too.
Yeah, and in my eyes, it's like, how much further is that area? You know what I'm saying? What, you go outside and then you end up in a whole other area of the world? Which, I don't know what they're doing with it, but...
Yeah. And it could be that Earth is like the smallest of them all.
Yeah, imagine Jupiter. Let's go to Jupiter. There's 40 levels on Jupiter. I think Destiny is going to be a big deal this year. I think there's a chance for it to fail, just like anything else. But it looks like it's pushing very hard to be a success. Just a little bit of beta that we all played has us all really excited. We all had nothing but good stuff to say about it. We had a ton of fun with it. And Tuesday we'll all be playing the game, and we can all really give more in-depth reactions to the full-fledged product. But if we go based on the beta alone, there's really not any complaints. We didn't have any issues with the network, getting into games, no server issues, really. Go ahead.
I think that was a big mark in my eyes, was when I worked that day. I worked the day that the beta came out, like the real beta, not the alpha. And I came home, and no lie, my whole fucking friends list was playing Destiny. The whole friends list. Like, I had 27 people on Destiny. Yeah. I was like, this makes zero sense at all, you know? And that's not including all my buddies that were still at work that were coming home to play Destiny.
Yeah.
It's like, that. It was crazy.
No issues either.
No, none.
If I had one complaint, it'd be that it took a long time for loading screens to happen.
Yeah, I was tired of looking at my spaceship.
Yeah.
We all are.
I don't know if Destiny will sell as good as Call of Duty, because Call of Duty has a pedigree and has a fan base. But I think Destiny will sell really well.
I think it's going to blow Call of Duty out of water.
It'll be the same or more. So.
With the way I look at it is, if they beat every reserve record with Grand Theft Auto and Call of Duty, granted it is on more consoles than Grand Theft Auto was, I think that's going to be, that's a feat right there. You're murdering all those games. That's saying a lot.
The only thing that Call of Duty shares with previous Call of Duty games is the name Call of Duty. Like, if you look at that game, it could be anything. Title could be anything. And then you look at the gameplay mechanics, and it could be anything.
It could be Titanfall 2.
It really could be.
That's scary. Isn't that the scary part, Briar? That's the thing that scares you the most, is that they could push it so far away from what made Call of Duty Call of Duty, it won't feel the same anymore. Isn't that the thing that has you worried the most?
Yeah, absolutely. I still enjoy Call of Duty.
One thing I will say that they did amazing is when they announced that when someone jumps and their jets go off, they show up on the map, which is genius. Like, you can equip the perk to do that, but I'm assuming whatever perk that is that you equipped when you don't show up on the map when you use your jets, it's not going to be that big of a deal. You know what I'm saying? Like, I feel you're going to have to turn off something good in order to have that.
I hope so. Balance issues are going to be big on this game, because not only do they have supply drops, but they got like every perk from every Call of Duty game. They brought, what is the one for the blast radius? Like, it enhances the amount of explosive damage you do. God damn, that was the worst perk ever.
Who knows what brought it back? I know.
What is the one where I forget which one it was, but when you get shot, you actually lay down and you can continue shooting at your enemies.
Last stand.
That didn't bring that back, did they? That was like the worst.
I hope not. No, it's Dead Man's Hand. They've had some bad perks in Call of Duty games, like some really annoying shit. And I thought that The Last of Us had just kind of sucked all of those into it.
Yeah, they got the blast radius on The Last of Us where you can make your bitch bomb explode three times farther.
I was just going to say, Martyrdom is like right up there with bitch bomb.
Oh, Martyrdom was worse than the heat-seeking grenades. Those grenades literally would follow you. Like, if you jumped out a window, they would hop out the window and follow you. I'm not shitting you. That was real.
Which Call of Duty had this?
That was God of War, the first
one. Yep, the me in my eyes, that was my favorite Call of Duty.
Oh, my God. People have, these super rose-colored glasses for that game. But there was some really annoying shit in that game.
Yeah, there was, but...
Martyrdom was one of those things. Those were heat-seeking. Go ahead. The maps? Yeah, the maps
were awesome. The maps were sick. I love those maps, dude. Yeah. That's what they should do, and that's what I was talking to, because with Battlefield, they're coming out with, like, the, not to talk about Battlefield, but they're talking about the last DLC that they're coming out with, and then they're coming out with another DLC that's not announced yet that's going to be remakes of the old maps, and they need to bring back Bad Company maps, just along the lines of Call of Duty needing to bring back older maps that are actually amazing and redoing them. Not like bullshit like Nuketown and Shipment. Like, bring me a real fucking map.
Shipment was a shitty map to begin with. Like, that was only fun to do, like, one versus ones on. I don't know why they brought that back.
Yeah. Didn't they bring back, like, Crash, what was that? The one with the plane, or the helicopter.
Helicopter.
Yeah. They brought that back, too, didn't they?
Yeah, I think so.
See, that was a good map.
That did they bring that back? I can't remember now.
I thought they did. Robbie, did they? You would know.
Would I?
Did they bring... did they... he said, what happened?
Would I know? I don't know.
What do you know?
did they bring back the crashed helicopter map on Call of Duty?
That was the COD 4 map, wasn't it?
Yeah.
Yes. Did they bring that back in any, like, didn't they bring that back in a...
It was Modern Warfare 2, I'm pretty sure. I was thinking the same one.
Okay. Did they bring it back from Modern Warfare 2?
Yeah, I'm pretty sure they did.
Yeah,
I remember playing that.
You're right. I just looked it up. Yeah, now they remake maps in that game, like, from 2 years ago. It's like, fuck you with Nuketown. I'm so sick of that goddamn map.
Yeah, but you know there's always going to be people who like Nuketown just because of the insanity of the level. I mean, I don't mind it not having it, but like when they brought Nuketown to Black Ops 2, I thought it was the best thing ever.
Oh my god, I played so much of it in Black Ops 1. I was so sick of it. Like when they said that was going to be the DLC that you got for pre-ordering the game, I was saying, great, now I don't have to pre-order.
Then they gave it to everybody.
Yeah, they added it to like every playlist, and it became the only thing you ever played in Black Ops 2.
Yeah,
which really sucked because I was really sick of it in Black Ops 1 because it was like the most popular map in Black Ops 2. That and Firing Range for Black Ops 1. And Firing Range got remade for Black Ops 2 as well. Studio.
Yeah.
Did you guys ever get a chance to see the new video I uploaded, What's Up with George Bush on 9/11?
No.
No.
It's part of my new series, What's Up With. And it's really good for the guys watching the show. If you guys get an opportunity, swing by my channel and check it out. But basically, it's going into what George Bush was doing on 9/11, and it's really weird. So if you guys don't know what he was doing at the moment that the World Trade Center was attacked, check out that video. It actually has a video on it of what he was doing, and it's very informative. I don't know how much it would matter in Canada, but you should watch it too, Robbie. Yeah, but definitely check it out. Definitely check it out. This is my new series, What's Up With, where I'm going to be covering things that really aren't talked about openly very much, and that's more of my passion. So I hope you guys enjoy that. If you guys get a chance to see it, let me know in the comment section below.
I did watch it, Beasley. I did.
What'd you think?
That is some Illuminati ass shit, as I posted in the comments. That's a bitch bomb. That's shit.
Yeah. Bitch bomb.
George Bush, the original bitch bomber.
Yeah, it's pretty good, but yeah, I just want to put that out there and let you guys know.
Should we wrap this one up, guys?
Yeah, we've gone for an hour and 52 minutes. I think they've seen enough of our beautiful mugs for a day.
Oh, there's really never enough of that.
Oh, right? Yeah.
I finally convinced Shannon that I'm cutting this thing off. So this week, this might be the last chance.
Are you? Oh, man.
Really?
Yeah.
Put it close to the camera so we can see it. Immortalize it on the show.
At least, I was going to say. At least your name's not like the beard or something. Right, the beard rabbit.
This thing's newer than my YouTube channel. I don't even like it, really. It's kind of fucking annoying, but...
Why do you have it?
Jam likes it.
Oh, okay.
Really?
Yeah.
I'm not going to ask what else you have that you don't like.
If you think this is long, you should see the...
G-string I'm wearing right now. Yeah, this G-string rides up my ass, but she loves it, so... I wear it every now and then.
You guys ever seen these before?
Yeah, those things are all right. Yeah. It tastes like Kool-Aid.
All right, guys. So let's start with BC Gamer because he went last time. What are you up to this week, man? What are we going to look forward to over on Candyman's channel?
How'd you know I was Candyman? What the hell?
What's up with Candyman? Where did that come from?
That's a good question. I've always wondered that, too. I think you might have told
us. We'll talk about that later. Just keep your kids inside. Anyway,
this goes along with those Magnum thumbsticks.
This week I'm going to be playing Destiny, man. It'll be all over the channel, and we'll probably be playing all that together. Whenever I get some downtime, I'm going to be playing The Last of Us. I still want to get into some Velocity.
Don't laugh.
I mean, it's true. I'm going to try to get some Velocity played on my Vita this week. But there's a lot of games. I just got 6 free games for PlayStation Plus, and whenever I get my PS Plus stuff, I always try to make time to actually get out there and play it because I appreciate Sony giving me all this free stuff. But yeah, Destiny this week for sure, that'll be the big game I'm playing.
Yeah. I think we should make a date for next Saturday to all get all together and do a player, if not a raid.
I'm always down. I'm in.
Is anybody else like kind of not looking forward to doing that early game shit, though?
I am, because it's the same shit over and over. Yeah,
I kind of want to just breeze through like all the Earth stuff at the beginning and just get to the new stuff.
I'm tired of old Russia, too.
If I could run Bungie and like kind of tell them what to do, I would have said, don't do the beta, just do the alpha.
Yep.
No, because then I wouldn't have been able to play it, and that would have sucked.
Well, we would have told you all about it.
I would have said, don't do the alpha and do the beta because more people got their hands on the beta, so that's testing the amount of traffic that they can handle. Which
that's true. All right, 95. What are you up to this week?
I'll be putting
taking a day off to play some Destiny. I know that much.
Yeah. I'll be going to the midnight, and then I'll be chilling at home pretty much for all of Tuesday playing Destiny, which is, I think, good because I need to use vacation days up, so it's giving me a reason to. Mm-hmm. And then on top of that, I'm going to try to get into Minecraft. I'm going to make an attempt. At least I'm going to make a grand attempt, Robbie, for you.
Nice.
And
then
I'm going to play
with friends and try and do something stupid.
Yeah, that's what I'm going to make. I'm going to make an attempt at that because my and buddy and his son play it. So we'll be playing that, and then Madden. I'm gonna try to do like a new series every week. I'm gonna play with one of my friends against them at a game, and then record it and post it to my thing. Whether it's with them or against them, whether it's with them or against them on whatever game, like depending on whether it's a shooter or no matter what, it's just gonna be like full audio of me and them playing.
Yeah, so that'll be fun, talking trash and having a good time.
Yeah, pretty much.
I like that.
Robbie? Yeah, other than that.
What do you got going on this week? You're playing a little Destiny, I know that much.
Oh, no, yeah, pretty much. I guess up until tomorrow night, we'll be playing Minecraft, Velocity, whatever else to pass the time, and then Destiny all the way, baby. Destiny is love and Destiny is life.
Robbie, did you finish Diablo 3 on PS4? I know you were playing it.
Yeah, I've beaten OX. I've played tons of it. I love it. Yeah, I've been playing it with some friends.
Did you go through it on Veteran? Did you start playing harder difficulties, or did you pretty much quit at Veteran?
I was playing it on Master, and that was a little tough at times, so I switched it down back to Expert. But even Expert is kind of easy. Yeah, I'm surprised.
Really? Yeah, that's the one disappointment I have about the game, is that the hardest difficulty unlocked at the beginning is Veteran.
Mm-hmm.
And then you got to beat the game to get a harder difficulty.
Yeah, I don't want to do that.
Yeah, weird. Anyway, Destiny.
Before you say what you're going to be playing, which I'm sure I can guess, are you going to beat Diablo on Veteran before you get into that, Brian?
I don't know. Maybe. The story is not awesome in that game, so there's not really a whole lot.
Yeah.
I just like playing it, and I think I'm going to get the exact same itch scratched by playing Destiny. So.
But you know, I heard that you could actually scratch that itch even more so than you would with Destiny by finishing Thief.
I never heard of that game. What's that?
I was so interested in that playthrough, and then you stopped it. I was confused.
I warned you. I told you right here. I was like, I don't like that game.
Yeah, he sure did. He said, I'm not even finished playing it. Yeah.
That game I liked at the beginning, but it just drudged on and on and on. Yeah, I just quit. You think I should finish the playthrough?
No, finish it on Tuesday. That's what you should do.
That'd be like torture. You have to beat Thief before you can play Destiny. No!
That would be too funny.
Oh, shit. It's not bad. It's just not for me. You know, it's too. You really got to be methodical. You really have to take your time and. You know, that's just not what I'm good at. That's not my core strength.
You talking about Thief or The Last of Us?
Yeah.
He just said, yeah.
I beat Thief. I beat that game, and it was a pain.
Yeah. Yeah. So I was, I'm looking forward to Destiny. Obviously, I'm going to be making some videos on Destiny. I'm really looking forward to kind of doing a Let's Play for Destiny, but I'm going to do it differently than most Let's Plays. I'm going to kind of, I'm just going to kind of do it at a casual pace. When I hit content that is fun to play, or I think is exciting, or if I'm playing with the crew here, then that's probably what I'm going to post for my Let's Play. I'm not going to post kind of every baloney little mission that you get while you're just kind of exploring. You know? I think that's what I'm going to do. I'm not sure. Because I just want to play that game a lot. So I know that I'm going to want to post it, too.
I'll be streaming it all on Tuesday, by the way, through the whole day.
I'll be streaming Tuesday night.
Well, let's be honest. Wednesday morning.
Yeah, Wednesday morning.
I'm trying to stay awake for one of those Tuesday night stream before.
He's like, I'm watching.
Yeah, I'll be there. Wait, what time are you getting on?
I get home at 1:30. I'll see you then.
Alright guys, great show. I'll see you guys next week.
Alright.